Father, Lord, we want to thank you for your children who have come here this morning to appreciate you. They come, oh God, realizing that you are the one who created them and that today is made possible by your grace. They come, oh God, expectant, waiting to hear your word. Let your word do them good. Let your word bring direction. Let your word bring renewal. Let your word bring transformation. In the name of Jesus. And Lord, I speak, oh God, that as I begin to minister, you will cause me to decrease. Let Jesus increase. Use me to speak to your children. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' name, we pray. Please shake somebody and say, God bless you. Shake somebody and pray. Just say, God bless you. Amen. Now, very quickly, what do we understand by renewal? I looked at the dictionary and I found out that renewal means when something is replaced, when something is improved, or something is made more successful. So this morning, I pray for you that whatever needs to be replaced for the glory of God to manifest in your life, today, let it be replaced. I also pray that whatever needs to be improved for your life to be one of honor and celebration, let it be improved. And whatever needs to be done to make your life more successful than it is now, God will do it today in the name of Jesus. Renewal is also giving something fresh life or strength. It could also mean to revive, to regenerate, to revitalize, to reinvigorate, to restore, to restorate. All these things can be used to explain renewal. I mentioned David just now. In spite of being king, in spite of the wealth at his disposal, he realized that something was wrong. He realized that something was wrong. And thank God that he had the knowledge and wisdom to cry to God so that God could revive him. God could restore him and God will renew him. It's my prayer that in this month of February, you will witness a renewal that will change your life for the better in the name of Jesus. Very quickly, I want to tell you 9 types of renewal. 9. And then we'll just mention one or two things and we'll pray. 9 types. There's a renewal that can change your destiny. There is a renewal that can change your destiny. In 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 9 to 10, you know the story of Jabez. His destiny was one of sorrow. Some of us, all through life, we are unable to separate ourselves from the circumstances of our birth. Which means, if your parents were poor, all through life you were poor. If your parents didn't go to school, it means that all through life you will not be able to go to school. Everything that you ought to have been is stopped by the circumstances of your birth. And Jabez was a child of sorrow. But he woke up one day and said, it cannot be like this. I am not comfortable living this kind of life. If my brothers and sisters are wretched, I do not have to be wretched. If my mother does not see anything good coming out of my life, I must not accept such a prayer. And so Jabez called to God. I said, God, please change my destiny. Let your hands be upon me. Enlarge my coast. Let it be well with me. And God answered his prayer. That same day, the life of Jabez changed. His story changed. I prophesy to somebody in this church this morning. As you cry out to God about your circumstances, about your situation, the God of heaven will answer you. Amen. And immediately your life will change for the better in the name of Jesus. Amen. So, your destiny can be renewed. Another area that can be renewed is your health. You'll be struggling with sickness. There are some people, from the day they were born until the day they die, is struggle. I've seen people with sickle cell from one sickness to the other until they die. HIV, from one sickness to the other until they die. Diabetics, hypertension. But in Matthew chapter 9, verse 20, a woman for 12 years was suffering one illness. Blood kept coming out of her on a daily basis. And she did everything. A woman who was rich became poor because every money that she had, she spent on trying to deal with this sickness. And nothing happened. Rather than getting better, she became worse. And one day, this woman heard about Jesus. And this woman resolved in her heart, if I can touch the hem of his garment, my life will be renewed. My health will be renewed. Her faith was strong. And this woman was able to go to where Jesus was, move the crowd, and she just laid her hand. She was not trying to kneel down or say, come and visit me or lay your hands on me. No. Her situation was too bad. So all she needed was, let me just touch. And the moment she did, her health was renewed. I pray for you this morning. Whatever sickness that is worrying you, whatever infirmity that you have, whatever disease that is bothering you, in this month of renewal, the God of heaven will heal you in the name of Jesus. Amen. I didn't hear amen. The God of heaven will heal you in the name of Jesus. Amen. A third way that you can be renewed is your finance. Many of us are living with debts. Many of us cannot make ends meet. And every day you are being tormented by those you owe. They have become your masters. When they appear, you go on your knees. They insult you in the presence of your wife, in the presence of your children. But because you are indebted to them, No matter what they do, no matter what they say, you keep quiet. In this month of renewal, God will change your story in the name of Jesus. We see a story in 2 Kings chapter 4 verse 1. A woman who was married to the son of the prophet. When her husband died and her children were about to be carried away, she knew she had to do something. And she ran to the man of God. And that decision that she took changed her story. At the end of the day, this woman who could not pay the debt of her husband became so rich that she could look after her children. A decision that she took, let me seek the face of God. Let me ask for direction. It changed the story. Her finances became renewed. I pray for you this morning that no matter what you are going through, God is going to renew your finances. God is going to renew your finances. God can renew your character. When I was talking about income and expenses, I mentioned that integrity is an asset. Your character can be an asset. A man can give you a loan of 10 million without telling you to sign an agreement, without asking you for interest based on who you are. Good man, trustworthy man, hardworking man, I will support him. How much do you want? Your character can make a way for you. But again, your character can become your problem. Don't you know him? A thief, a rapist, an armed robber, a cultist. And you might see yourself struggling. That's why people who have gone to jail, they find it very difficult. Because in many applications, they might ask the question, are you a convict or not? The moment you say yes, they are not interested in knowing that you have changed. They just simply carry your file and dump away. So sometimes, your character, your reputation, your integrity can become a problem. But your character can be renewed. God can change your character in such a manner that people will look at you and say, is this same person? When Saul began to prophesy, they looked at him and said, is this Saul among the prophets? I pray for you this morning. No matter what you were known for before, God will give you a new name. God will give you a new name. God will cause men and women to begin to respect you. God will cause men and women to begin to favor you. In the name of Jesus. Psalm 51 verse 7. David told God, he said, clean me. Wash me and make me clean. That's why I said, he has the ability to renew your character. When God makes you clean, people will look at you and they will see a different person completely. I'm sure you all know the story of Paul. Look at his past. Look at what he became. God is going to change you for the better in the name of Jesus. God is going to change you for the better in the name of Jesus. God can renew your strengths. And I want us to read that. Let's look at that. Isaiah 40. Isaiah chapter 40. Verse 28. Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard? And that's the greatest problem. We do not know, we do not hear. So here it says, hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard? That the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increaseth strength. Even the youths shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. Praise the Lord. Your strength can be renewed. There are many things in life that you continue to pray to God for strength. Yeah, God is telling you, what even young men cannot do, I can make you do them. What you could not do in your early years, I can make you do it in your old age. And here, God is saying, those that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. What does it mean to wait upon the Lord? One of it is to be in a mood of prayer and fasting. When a man is fasting and praying, it means that he's trying to seek the attention of God. Fasting is not hunger strike. Fasting is not an exercise to slim down. It's a spiritual thing to seek the face of God. And God is saying, those that want to seek my face shall renew their strengths. When they would have become weaker, I will make them stronger. Because it is the spirit that strengthens the physical. As of as many of you are waiting upon the Lord, let me assure you that you are going to come out of this month stronger than you have ever been in the name of Jesus. Amen. The battles you could not win before, you begin to win them in the name of Jesus. Amen. The things you were not able to do before, you begin to do them in the name of Jesus. Amen. Waiting on the Lord does not only stop at fasting. When a man seeks God, you begin to meditate on the things of God. You keep reading the scriptures. You keep praying. You keep coming to church, wanting to hear the word of God. You are waiting. There is something you are expecting from God. And God is saying, for such people, one of the things I will do for them is that I will renew their strengths. Are you weak? As life made you weak. Sometimes situations can make you weak. The poverty around you can make you weak. The betrayal around you can make you weak. The lack of help can make you weak. No matter the situation you are going through, God will strengthen you in the name of Jesus. God will strengthen you in the name of Jesus. And you know, because of this verse, God dropped the prayer. The moment you go through that verse, Isaiah 40, Once you end at 31, the next chapter, Isaiah 41, God raised a prayer point. Many of you just read scripture, just stop in one place. But the next verse, to emphasize the importance of renewing your strength, God raised a prayer point in Isaiah 41, verse 1. He said, "Keep silent before me, O islands, and let the people renew their strength. Keep silence before me, O islands, and let the people renew their strength." What does this mean? Their islands. Islands, apart from the water that it contains, are in isolated places. Islands are not what you see just by the corner. If not, they will not be called islands. And yet, God is revealing that from far places, there are voices raised against you, saying that you must remain weak. And so God spoke. He said, "Keep silent before me, O islands, and let the people renew their strength." So I pray for you this morning. Every island, every gathering, every group that is speaking against your life, wherever they are, keep silent in the name of Jesus. Keep silent in the name of Jesus. Islands that you are not aware of, who continue to speak against your health. They speak against your finance. They speak against your character, doing everything to keep you where you are. This morning we join forces with the host of heaven and we say, "Oh, islands, keep silent in the name of Jesus." Your life can be renewed. Psalm 103. Psalm 103, verse 1. "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgiveth all thy iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemed thy life from destruction, who crowned thee with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfied my mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagle." I wish many of you know that there's no part of your life that God cannot renew. There's nothing God cannot do for you if only you are able to cry to him. This morning I pray every area of your life God will renew in the name of Jesus. Every area of your life God will renew in the name of Jesus. Every destruction that the enemy has planned for your life, God will redeem you in the name of Jesus. God will crown your head with loving kindness. With tender mercies will God satisfy you in the name of Jesus. The reason why I'm taking the pains is to make you to be eager to ask God for renewal. Because when God renews you, it makes you a brand new creature. It makes you better than you were before. An improved version. Successful version. And by the grace of God, that is who you will become in the name of Jesus. God can renew you in knowledge. My people perish for lack of knowledge. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Colossians chapter 3. Colossians chapter 3. Colossians chapter 3, verse 9. Lie not one to another, seeing that you have put off the old man with his deeds, and have put on the new man, which is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created him. Let us stop lying to ourselves. It's bad enough to lie to others, but when you lie to yourself, you lie to your wife, you lie to your children, you lie to your parents, who do you really believe you are deceiving? There is no need to lie to one another. Renewal means that you have made up your mind to drop that part that lies. There is no way you can be renewed if you want to continue the old way. There is a decision to change. And when you do that, God says you will find out that it's like you have put on a new man. And that new man is renewed in knowledge. The moment you make that decision, there are things that will begin to come to you that you were not aware of before. For many of us here, the only thing that stands against you from getting to where you ought to get to is what you don't know. There is something you need to know that will change your life. Once the secret is revealed, your life has changed. Knowledge is the secret. That's why the scripture says the secret things belong to God, but the revealed things belong to us and our children forever. What you possess is what you know. And a man can be renewed in knowledge. I speak to your life this morning that from today you will increase in knowledge. From today, you'll be renewed in knowledge. No one again will look at you and say, "He's a foolish man." No, they will not say so. They will not say so. They will look at you and they will marvel. How can this man be this wise? How come this man is so smart? Not dismiss you and say, "That foolish man." It will not be your portion in the name of Jesus. It will not be your portion in the name of Jesus. Your mind can be renewed. When the choir is about to minister this morning, they talked about Romans chapter 12, verse 1. Apostle Paul was speaking to the Romans. He said, "I beseech you, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice." Present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And in verse 2, he said, "And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable will of God." Renewal brings transformation. Your mind can be renewed. If your mind is not renewed, you will continue to think small. They wanted to give David a wife. And the king came to David and said, "Come and marry my wife. Come and marry my daughter." And David, at that time, in spite of the fact that God had anointed him, still had an inferiority complex. And David said, "How can I marry the king's daughter?" So rather than give the daughter to David, the daughter was given to somebody else. He had an inferiority mentality. Many of you, the reason why you are not rich is that you have a poor mentality. A poor mentality is when somebody gives you a blank check. "How much do you want me to give to you?" And what you need is 10,000. But you look at yourself. How can a poor man be expecting 10,000? So you tell the man, please, if you can help me with 1,000. And the man brings out 10,000. I even thought you needed more than that. And he gives you 1,000. Your mind has to be renewed to be able to understand who you are. So that when you ask, when you think, your thinking will be different. Your thinking right now is that it's not possible. It can't be done. It can't be done. Who said? Your mind has to be renewed. Your mind has to be transformed. What does God want from me? God said you are the head and not the tail. You are above and not beneath. Then why are you thinking as if you are on the ground? What circumstances bring is not the reality of your life. It's a picture meant to discourage you from attaining where God wants you to get to. So mind can be renewed. Praise the Lord. And finally, your spirit. Create in me a clean heart and renew a right spirit. He asked God, he said, God, I'm not satisfied with my heart. My heart, I'm not happy with it. Please, I want a new heart. Remove the one there, remove it, give me a new one. And then, I want my spirit to be renewed. Why? As many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. Not just any spirit. Not a spirit that will make me walk into error. A spirit that understands the will of God. A spirit that can direct me to do the right things. Not a spirit that makes me lost. But a spirit that makes me fear God and do His will. And when he made that prayer to God, God said, fantastic. I pray to God this morning that God will renew your spirit. God will renew your spirit. God will renew your spirit in the name of Jesus. 9 points I mentioned. Very quickly, I'm going to end by going to the road to renewal. 9 things I mentioned. 1 was destiny. 2 was health. 3 was finance. 4 was character. 5 was strength. 6 was life. 7 knowledge. 8 mind. And 9 spirit. John chapter 5. I will soon round up. John chapter 5. Verse 5. John chapter 5, verse 5. And a certain man was there, which had an infirmity 38 years. When Jesus saw him lie and knew that he had been now a long time in that case, he saith unto him, wilt thou be made whole? And that way of saying, do you want to be renewed? The impotent man answered him, sir, I have no man to renew me. When the water is troubled, to put me into the pool. No man to help me, no man to assist me. But while I'm coming, another stepped down before me. Jesus said unto him, rise, take up thy bed. And immediately the man was made whole, and took up his bed and walked. And on the same day was the Sabbath. There's one verse there I will still mention. But this man, for 38 years, remained the way he was. Pathetic. 38 years. His biggest mistake was that he kept hoping that somebody will help him. Help him. I have some friends who spent close to 10 years at home, waiting for somebody to help them to go abroad. 10 years, not doing anything. My senior brother will send me to America. My senior brother will send money down. Meanwhile, the senior brother has forgotten about the junior brother. Even if he remembers, he's battling with his own problem he cannot tell at home. In America, there are problems. The man is battling with problems. And the man who cannot solve his own problem is being seen as a savior by a man who has no knowledge. So for 38 years, this man made the mistake of looking for somebody to help him. And you can see how wicked human beings can be. What did this man want? Somebody to push him into the water when the water was troubled. And he found nobody. If something as small as that, the man found nobody, who do you think is going to help you solve the problem that you have? So for 38 years, this man's life could not be renewed. He wasted 38 years until Jesus had mercy on him. This man did not become renewed because he took an opportunity. No, he took the mercy of God. This man would have died in that place. So Jesus stepped in and Jesus renewed his life. But there was something Jesus told this man in verse 14. Afterward, Jesus fended him in the temple and said unto him, behold, thou art made whole, thou hast been renewed. Sin no more, lest a worse thing come unto thee. Sin no more, lest a worse thing come unto thee. Big revelation. What was Jesus telling this man? Even though I had mercy on you, even though I made you whole, there's something I need to tell you quickly. And the only reason why I'm telling you now is that you were faithful enough to come back to church to thank God. If you had not bothered, I would not have told you, and you would have returned back to your problem, but it would have been worse for you. What's your problem? Sin. Sin is a barrier. It's a major obstacle. He says, sin no more, lest a worse thing happen to thee. Don't take God's grace for granted. I have renewed you. But let me warn you, don't do it again. 38 years you suffered was your sin. Every time, evil angels would have helped you, the islands were speaking out. A sinner, a man who raped a small girl, a sinner, and the angels had to keep quiet. There were islands crying out about your life. That is why nothing could be done about it. I had to, after 38 years. Sin no more. Some of you wonder why you hear messages in church and you don't begin to see the messages coming to manifestation. Did the message change you? It's not enough to say amen. I want to claim the message without obeying the instruction in the message. Did the message change you? If the message did not change you, the benefit of the message cannot come to you. Hebrews chapter 6. Look at what God said. Hebrews chapter 6. Hebrews chapter 6 verse 4. For it is impossible. Anytime God uses this word, be very careful. For it is impossible for those who were once enlightened and have tasted of the heavenly gifts and were made partaker of the Holy Ghost and have tasted the good word of God and the powers of the world to come, if they shall fall away, to renew them again unto repentance, seeing they crucify to themselves the Son of God afresh and put him to an open shame." You know, ideally, repentance can bring renewal. That's what he's talking about here. Renew them again unto repentance. But God says, can you continue in sin and expect grace to abound? Renewal is grace. When God decides to change you and make you better, it's grace. Say, can I give you this? When you are an habitual sinner all the time, God is saying, God is not saying, I don't want you to repent. No. God is saying, don't take my grace for granted. If you want to repent, repent. David repented. God answered him. But if you want to begin to think that repentance can be an everyday affair, every Sunday affair, then you will find out that repentance will not bring renewal. That's why I said, don't sin again. If you try it again, a more terrible thing will happen to you, which means you will die with your problem. Nobody will save you. So in 1 John, the advice that God gave is still valid. 1 John chapter 1. 1 John chapter 1. Verse 9. If we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. You know, he didn't say to cleanse us from that sin. A confession, genuine confession, will trigger God to remove all the ordinances written against you. But do it genuinely. If we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Many of us, we are ashamed to confess our sins. We know there are things we do that is not right. But what you don't understand is that there is nothing you can hide from God. There's nothing. So why don't you just confess and say, God, help me to deal with this sin. My weakness has become my sin. Help me to deal with it. Give me the power, the will to say no. And God will answer you. But when you continue to pretend, as if God does not see, then you are bringing the wrath of God upon you. I want to see manifestation of renewal this month. But you must take the step. The step of saying, no. If I'm going to seek God, I cannot hide anything from him. There's no part of me that he will not see. So let me confess to him. Let me ask him for strength and the will to be able to deal with my weaknesses. I'm going to take two more verses and then we'll close because of time. Philippians chapter 4. Philippians chapter 4. Philippians chapter 4, verse 8. It says, "Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, If there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on those things. Those things which you have both learned and received and heard and seen in me, do, and the God of peace shall be with you. What you think is critical to what you do. Everything you are doing is a manifestation of what you think. And God is saying that for renewal to start, you must deal with your thoughts. Your actions are simply the manifestation of your thoughts. Ask God to help you deal with your thoughts. Anything that you do is what you thought. If your thought says no, your body will not say yes. So God is saying, begin to think good things. Have a parameter for the things you think. Are those things true? Are they honest? Are they just? Are they pure? Are they lovely? Are they of good report? Is there any virtue in them? Is there any praise? Will God be glorified? Say, when you think of these things, you will find that God will begin to dwell in you. The moment God is in you, there is no way that the renewal you desire will not begin to manifest in every area of your life. Finally, 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. That is the key to renewal. If any man be in Christ, is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things have become new. That is like a definition of renewal. If any man be in Christ, all things are passed away. All things have become new. Renewal has started. You will find out that in all the cases we mentioned, Christ intervened. God intervened. His prophet intervened. In this month of renewal, do you want God? Do you want Christ to intervene in your life? Bow down your heads in prayers. Bow down your heads in prayers. My greatest prayer is that God will transform all of you. I want to be able to look at you and say, these were people who came as if they were nothing. But today, see what God has turned them to become. See how great, see how respected, see how successful they have become. And that power that brings change is renewal. Christ. We give you the renewal that will turn your destiny, that will turn your life, that will turn your head, that will turn your finances, that will turn your mind, your spirit. But genuinely, genuinely, you must agree to come to Him. Make up your mind and say, no, I can no longer be a servant to sin. He says, sin no more, lest a worse thing will come upon you. The next thing might be death. Don't take any chance anymore. Come to Him. Are you here this morning You are struggling with sin. Sin is holding you. You are doing things you don't like. Jesus wants to help you. That struggle can be overcome if Christ partners with you. You can't do it alone. Stop struggling alone. You can't. You have failed many times in the past. Christ can help you. He can hold your hands and strengthen you. And you will become an overcomer. Satan will flee from you. And you will find that you will witness renewal in every part of your life. Are you willing this morning to come back to Him and say, Lord, strengthen me. Help me. I accept you wholeheartedly as my Lord and Savior. I can't continue like this. This year, let it be better than last year. Help me, oh Lord. When you cry out genuinely to God, God will hear you. Are you here this morning? You want to embrace Him. You are tired of sin. You want to embrace Him. And let Him stand. And begin to see what He will do in your life. Lift up your hand wherever you are. Wherever you are, lift up your hand. God bless you. God bless you. Please come. If you are lifting up your hands, come quickly. Let me join you in prayers. Come. Come quickly. Just stand up and come. Don't lift up your hands. Don't be ashamed. Just come. I saw many hands lifted. Come up. Don't be ashamed. You lifted up your hands. Stand up and come to the altar. I want to join you in prayers. Come. If you lifted up your hand, come. Come wherever you are. Come. If you are coming, come. Thank you, my brother. If you are coming, come. I'm going to pray. If you want to come, you can come. Father, Lord, I want to thank you for your Son who have heard your word. Your word has profited him. And Lord, he has come before your altar this morning, asking, O God, for the complete renewal. Asking, O God, for the spirit of adoption. Asking, O God, for a separation from sin. Asking, O God, that His name be raised from the book of death and written in the book of life. As your Son comes, O God, affirm His acceptance of Christ in His life. I pray that you would uphold Him with your right hand of righteousness. I ask, Lord, that you will strengthen him. I ask, Lord, that you will separate him from sin, from every wile of the enemy. From today, O God, let his life be renewed. Let his mind and his spirit be renewed. Every aspect of his life, let your presence bring renewal. Bless him, bless his home, bless his family, bless the works of his hand. Job, his latter end was more glorious than his beginning. I pray for you, my brother, that your latter end will be more glorious than your beginning. You will begin to witness a new lease of life. The favor of God will continue to rest upon you. And from today, no weapon of the enemy fashioned against you will prosper. I cover you with the blood of the Lamb, and I decree that it shall be well with you. In Jesus' name, we pray. God bless you. Now, just bow down your heads where you are. Just bow down your heads. In which area of your life do you want God to touch? Which area of your life? God appeared to Solomon at night. And God said, ask anything of me, and I will give to you. He asked God for wisdom. He asked God for knowledge. And God was pleased. And God gave him knowledge and added more blessings to it. Is there an area of your life that bothers you? In this month of waiting, in this month of seeking the face of God, I want you to talk to Him. Also intercede for any member of your family who might not be carrying the grace you are carrying. Their lives are in danger, but your intercession can cover them. Plead for your loved ones and ask for your grace to extend to them. Many will die this year. Let your grace and your presence here with God remove your family from that list. No member of your family will be among the casualties. You will not be victims. You will not be bereaved. There will be no loss in your home. People will celebrate this year. People will rejoice. Plead with God to put you on that list, a member of your family. Home of celebration, of thanksgiving. Let there be rejoicing among your family. Let good tidings come forth even this month. And in every area of your life, let the hands of God touch you for good. Let there be a renewal in your health, in your finances. Let your life be renewed. Let the old renew, receive strength. Let the young receive knowledge. Everything that you need to make your life better, let God give to you. Father, Lord, I want to join my faith with the prayers your children have prayed. I ask, Lord, that you would answer them. This month, many of them are waiting on you. I ask, Lord, that you would honor them in their moment of waiting. Let the heavens open unto them. Let their prayers be answered. Let their blessings not be delayed. Let their renewal come speedily. Before the end of this month, let wonderful testimonies spring forth from each and every one of them. In Jesus' name, pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. Now, before... Thank you. Before...